Hey friends, let's talk some more about plants. I want to talk to you about the parts of the plant and their functions, as well as the stages of growth that's involved in the plant's life cycle. Then let's take a look at some seeds so that we can compare them. All right, let's come down here to the plant diagram on the table where we can see the stages of growth of a bean plant. And you can see a nice cross section for what grows below the soil and what grows above the soil. Let's start with the seed, putting the seed into the ground, into the soil. A seed already has everything it needs inside of it to start to grow. Once that mixes with enough water and air and sunshine, a little green shoot pops out, and then you can see some little roots start to form. That's a seedling. So we have the seed and then our seedling, and now look at this next. That's a baby plant. That's a sprout. Look at the roots. They're digging down deeper, really soaking up all the water and nutrients from the soil and passing that up through a stem that we have popping above the soil now with some leaves at the end of it starting to develop. And this seed casing that's hooked to the leaves will just eventually fall off on its own, and the leaves will turn upright towards the sun when they're ready to soak in some more sunshine. From that sprout, we're going to go to the plant. This is our bean plant. Look at those roots really anchoring down that plant. It's going to continue to soak up everything it needs to and pass it up through that stem, which is like a straw. It's going to suck everything up and send it to the leaves. The leaves are the food-making factory of the plant. It's going to mix the sunshine with the water and the nutrients to make food for the plant. And at the same time, the leaves are going to give off oxygen for us so that we can breathe. So it'll take in carbon dioxide for the plant to make food and then give off oxygen for us. Let's look up at the top of the bean plant. There's two little nodules there. Those are the buds. Okay, eventually what will happen, there will be some strings that come from those buds and the beans will hang down over the bean plant where you'll see the vegetable. If this was a flower, the buds would open up to reveal some petals so that you could see a flower, okay? And inside a flower, there would be some seeds. And I actually have some seeds from a flower on a plate here for you to see. These are some zinnia seeds. So what would happen, you would see seeds like this in the center of the plant, and sometimes they're dispersed. It can happen naturally. They'll just fall off the plant onto the ground. The wind could blow them around to disperse them, or an animal might come by it and bump their body up against it, and some seeds could get stuck in their fur, and that could carry the seed somewhere else. Or an animal could even take a seed and bury it so that it can try to eat it later on. Sometimes though, they forget about it. But if any of those seeds end up in the right spot where it gets enough water, enough air, and enough sunshine, that plant can start to grow from that place. Isn't that cool? All right, now I wanna label the plant with you. So let's set these seeds aside and let's look at our labels. And let's go back to that first stage. What did we have first that we put into the ground? That was the seed, you got it. And then when that little green shoot came out, what was that? That was the seedling. Okay, from there we had our baby plant. That was known as the sprout. And from the sprout, we moved on to the plant, the actual bean plant. So we'll put plant beside that. Now let's get some of those parts labeled. Okay, we've got the roots soaking up everything like a sponge from the soil. Right down here at the bottom in the soil, we've got the stem acting as a straw, sending that water and nutrients to the leaves, and the leaves are the food-making factory, okay? All right, and the flower, if there would be a flower, this is a bean plant, but if there would be a flower, would be at the top. Okay, so that's something that you'll need to do, label the plant parts, and then we're going to take a look at our seeds now. So we're going to move over here across the table where we have some seeds, and I just want you to notice they're all different sizes, all different shapes, colors, and kinds. We've got some vegetable seeds up at the top and some flower seeds down here at the bottom. As a kindergartner, what you need to know is that each seed will grow into its own kind of plant, okay? So we can't get a tomato from a zinnia seed. We can't get a pansy from a radish seed. We can't get an alyssum plant from a cucumber. Each seed will grow into its own kind of specific plant, okay? All right, guys, we made it through our plant lesson. You know so much about plants and seeds now, so what I need you to do, you're going to label a plant, just like we did here together, and you're also going to order the stages of the life cycle from first to last. All right, I know you can do it. Job well done, everybody. See you later.